Tonight on CTV News, we go behind the scenes of the biggest events of the racing calendar. The trams come full circle, and Arana Park's latest babies go public.
Broadcasting across Canterbury, from the CTV studio, this is First at Five.
Good evening. It's the biggest events on the racing calendar here in Christchurch. Cup Day, a day where there's perhaps far too much drinking, plenty of makeup and lavish-looking hats. But racing is all part of it, of course, and CTV's Rob Coate-Williams got a behind-the-scenes look at the preparations.
It's sort of payday for most trainers, really. It's a day that you try to peak them for the day, you know, like it's always great, sort of like the pinnacle of the calendar. So, yeah, no, it's always a bonus if you can have two or three in on cup day.
So how do you get a horse to peak because they're an athlete?
Yeah, it's just really picking races to suit and just timing, really, and actually working towards, you're actually going to the races with the intentions of with them improving every race. So it's, yeah, it's, and you change your training around a little bit leading into a big race, you know, depending on where they're at their preparation. Yeah,
huge crowds. Do the horses get a bit sort of skittery because of that?
There's definitely a percentage of horses that would be affected by it, and then you've got the likes of the Terror to Love and those sort of horses that lift for the occasion, you know. I definitely think, you know, they know when it's game time, and they definitely do lift on the big days, you know.
And what's the criteria for you to have a horse in the main race? Because you did one, but you withdrew him.
Yeah, would have made the field, Jason Rules, as it worked out, but his blood wasn't 100 and we weren't happy with him. So we sort of didn't really just want to be making up the numbers. But, you've got to have been in the lead-up races. There's half a dozen lead-up races that you accumulate points sort of thing on the fact that where you finish, you know. So, as it's worked out, I think most horses that are actually nominated have got a start in the Cup this year.
We've all got a pretty big day. All the owners and all the trainers think, you know, it's up to us now, basically. They've done their job, so all responsibility comes to us.
You've got 10 drives today.
I got 10 drives, yes. I've got a busy day. I've got a lot to think about before I drive the Cup.
So what do you have to think about before you get to that start line and take off?
Not really. You know everything. You know all the horses, so, you know, all your homework should be done by then.
I guess you also can predict what the other drivers are going to do and where they're going to put their horses.
Well, I think the biggest thing is the start. You know, no one knows after the start what's going to happen, so to me that's the biggest part of the whole race.
And nerves? I mean, you've been doing this a long time.
Oh, I guess you still get a few nerves. I think everyone does. It doesn't matter if they say no, but I'm sure they do. It's all right when you get out on the track. It's all the hype beforehand.
Yes, the hype beforehand indeed, while Canterbury health professionals are reminding people not to take their health for granted this Cup Week.
Cup Week is finally here, but one of Canterbury's top doctors is warning Cantabrians need to be careful if they want to stay healthy. Canterbury Medical Officer of Health Dr. Alistair Humphrey says people attending the various show and cup events, or even taking advantage of the warmer, longer days to get stuck into the garden, need to take steps to avoid getting one of the many illnesses that can emerge in late spring and early summer. It's the simple things like washing your hands that can prevent several nasty diseases, a timely reminder with the AMP show in Christchurch this week. Dr. Humphrey says farm animals may look harmless, but they can pass on serious diseases. Even an innocent-looking baby lamb can be harbouring something nasty. Unsurprisingly, children are most at risk, as they don't always wash their hands after touching farm animals. Show weekend is also a popular time for gardeners, and Cantabrians are being reminded of the dangers of using potting mix and compost. Dr. Humphrey says using this can increase people's chances of being exposed to harmful bacteria. Scaremongering or helpful advice, you be the judge.
Well, Canterbury and Japan's Sendai province share a common bond. Major earthquakes destroyed both within weeks in 2011, but that bond has now become stronger than ever. Marcus Gibbs reports.
Standing tall above Christchurch, this single street lamp has been sent to the city from Japan. It joins four others that have already been installed along this stretch of Park Terrace. However, this lamp carries a special meaning. In the wake of the 2011 Christchurch earthquakes, Sendai City was rocked by a magnitude 9 earthquake. A giant tsunami then struck the Tohoku region, killing 15,000 people. Now the city of Sendai hopes that this lamp will bond the two cities together.
Being part of this project, moving forward as one, together as both cities that have been through large-scale earthquakes, partaking in this project will help with the recovery of both Christchurch and Sendai City.
Sendai's coastal region was badly hit. Thousands of people lost their homes. Sendai now wants this lamp post to be a gesture of solidarity for Christchurch.
Even though Christchurch and Sendai are separated by around 10,000 kilometres, by participating in this project, it brings both Christchurch and Sendai closer together.
The artist behind the project is looking forward to the end of 2015, when 21 lampposts will line the street, each one from a different country and culture.
If a city suffers such a strong event, it may feel that's kind of on its own, it's separated, and because of the networking of Solidarity Grid, I think it shows a strong solidarity which goes from Christchurch to a lot of international cities.
The cities sending lampposts to Christchurch include Serbia, Sydney, Dusseldorf and Belgrade. The artist's vision is fast becoming a reality.
Yeah, that was a dream. That first of all it was an idea, and it to make it happen, it was a lot of work behind the scene, behind the curtain, invisible work done by the team of Scape and by City Council, and then it kind of merged and matches here.
Sendai's lamppost is unique and features a bronze cast statue of the founder of Sendai. The Japanese hopes he watches over Christchurch.
The person on top of the lamp is Date Masamune. He's the founder of Sendai, or the feudal lord of Sendai City, from 1601. So these street lamps started around 30 years ago when they were set up. And as you can see on top, Date Masamune, he overlooks Sendai and protects Sendai. So to take him from Sendai, bring him all the way to Christchurch and set him up there, he hopes that he will also overlook Christchurch and protect Christchurch as well.
The plan is for an app to launch featuring stories of each of the lamps. The project will wrap up at the end of next year, but the lampposts will continue watching over Christchurch for years to come. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Very special indeed. Well, still to come on CTV News, locals celebrate Armistice Day, and at last, more community pools are open just in time for summer.
Kids Television is right here on CTV. With an exciting range of kids programming, join in on all the fun Saturday 7am to 8:30am right here on CTV.
Located at the foot of the Port Hills, Berrymead Golf offers a spectacular location for any occasion. Make a dream wedding a reality with private use of our green function room, outdoor garden courtyard, large marquee and stunning gazebo. Or for your next conference, enjoy the relaxed atmosphere of Berrymead Golf, offering a private, spacious conference room with special deals to make any break a true break. All with customised catering from the WOW Cafe. Berrymead Golf, 50 Berrymead Park Drive, right next to the Berrymead Heritage Park.
Avoid the monkeys when it comes to relocating. Trust A1 Movers, a family business since 1993 that guarantees a professional job every time. We carefully handle and wrap your valued items, ensuring they have a safe journey. Secure storage and insurance options are also available.
A1 Movers, the careful, caring moving company.
Oi! Blackwells has a proud history presenting leading vehicle brands, extensive backup and service for a total one-stop driving experience. Holden, Mazda and HSV new and used vehicle sales, servicing, parts, paint and panel, Isuzu truck sales and service, all together in one convenient location. More selection, more value, more quality and more reasons to make Blackwells your number one choice. Visit Blackwells today, corner Waterloo Racecourse Road, Sockburn, or online at blackwells.co.nz.
Southern Newsweek is an Otago-based news bulletin. Watch this every week to stay in touch with what's happening in and around your community. Stay in the know with Southern Newsweek, 11am Saturdays, right here on CTV.
Welcome back to CTV News. Well, it couldn't have come at a better time. Several community swimming pools here in Christchurch have opened for the first time since the quakes. Marcus Gibbs with the good news.
Three local paddling pools are reopening for the first time. Waltham, Scarborough and Littleton's Norman Kirk pools are all reopening, and hundreds if not thousands of little Cantabrians are expected to jump in the water this summer. The new and refurbished pools will join Jelly Park, Hallswell and Templeton as the 2014-15 summer pool season hits. Festivities officially begin this Saturday with the opening of the Jelly Park and Hallswell pools. Christchurch City Council Recreation and Sports Unit Manager John Fasel says the three pools reopening are a bit of a present for the communities that have been without for nearly 4 years. Several welcome back pool parties will be thrown to celebrate. Show weekend sees the city's paddling pools opening for the summer, including New Brighton Whale Pool, Christchurch Botanic Gardens, Aberley Park, Edgar McIntosh Park, Spencer Park and Morden Park. The paddling pool at Scarborough will follow before Christmas. When it was demolished, a small crowd of local supporters held protests, but the brand new facility promises to deliver. The council is spending $780,000 on rebuilding the popular pool. This beloved favourite, which has been a familiar sight on Sumner's seaside landscape, is scheduled to reopen by Christmas. The Sumner Hub Community Group is leading a fundraising program to find the extra money necessary to add some finishing touches to the pool, including seating, a shade sail, trees and plants. The community will host an opening event in December.
Always some positive news for you. Now, comedian Chopper Reed is in town, and CTV News decided to pinch him off Canterbury Live and put him to work. We sent him out to the streets of Christchurch to check out the local rebuild, including the $300 million development, The Terrace.
How's it going? Do you mind having a quick chat? Do you want to have a quick chat? I don't know what about. Try to interrupt your lunch. What have you guys been working on today?
Put some steel up?
Yeah, nice. It's all coming along pretty well.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah. G'day, it's Chopper here, and I'm with, what's your name, Chief?
James Stallion Balls McLaughlin.
Him? And how's everything going here, mate? You're rebuilding Christchurch single-handed?
Yeah, just started by myself here, just working my way down at the terraces. Here.
How's progress? As good as you'd like?
Yeah, look, we can't ask for anything more than what we've got.
No. Maybe a couple extra workers, if it's just you, it'll take a while.
We've got mate Smeekle over there, Kieran. He's come on board just this week, and really proud to have him on. Young guy, young blood, tons of energy.
Yeah, nice.
Bursting at the seams.
So two of you reckon you can get it sorted?
Yeah, probably between both us, yeah.
It's not a bad view up here, mate.
Yes, it's not a bad view, mate, yeah.
So how long have you been on this site?
Probably on and off, probably about 6 months. We've been working here, sort of on and off, coming backwards and forth.
Get a third person or something, maybe, to help you.
It's Hagen.
Yeah,
I like his style. Yeah, okay, I'll note that and we'll get on with it.
Yeah, give us a call. I need something to do. I'm bloody starting to keg up a bit.
Well, I think you're not too bad, actually. I don't think you should be saying hello yourself.
Oh, good on you, mate.
Yeah.
I like your bloody say what you want approach to things. Give me another compliment.
Like your tats.
Thank you. They're just chucking the harness on in case I get one of those acid flashbacks again and I think I can fly. I want this bloody finished by December, mate. We haven't even got the walls on.
Mate, we don't even know how to spell December, is it?
Oh, well, I'll tell you after November. So,
all right, so we're just going to stack that over there, mate. That'd be great. Just put it in front of the crane here. We'll get that crane into the way. It's all nice stacking.
Yeah, good.
A bit of enthusiasm. Probably about a 3 out of 10.
When's lunch?
You can have lunch whenever you want.
Alright.
Come in there, Chopper. Get in there, me old mate. Oh, yeah.
Kick a couple off the platform kind of thing?
Kick a couple off, mate, but health and safety standards probably don't recommend that.
Yeah, I can imagine not. I'm the practical one, and you're the one who's giving it a bit of zhuzh. I like it. You want a couple of minutes without the no. You need to be about, 40 metres in the air or something?
Well, this thing goes 42, so 2 metres extra.
Yeah, nice. I should That should be just enough to get away from him. There's some stuff that you've wanted to say every now and then, and you're like, oh, better not, someone will have a whinge. Because that pretty much describes every day of my life.
That pretty much describes a lot of what's going on now.
Is there anything you want to get off your chest now, to me, just between you and me?
I just think things need to be happening a bit quicker.
So you guys are originally from Christchurch?
Christchurch is good.
Have you got one of them in my size? We're about the same size, aren't we? Not to be rude. Oh, this is going very well already.
Look at this.
I don't want to muck it up, though.
Oh, you'll never muck it up.
Oh, yeah. Hope the checkbook's in there somewhere still. Where's the sleeve?
Aren't those the things you have to put stones on top? Otherwise they sort of bounce around. Hey, it's a pretty good fit. Look at that. Oh, it looks pretty good. And I gather one of the things is you've changed your name to Anthony Gop, I see already.
Yeah, that's right. I'm moving up in the world. What do you get up to here, bro?
Just rebuilding Christchurch.
Yeah, nice. You're one of the two blokes who are on it.
Yeah,
mate. Three now.
Yeah, three, including yourself.
Yeah, nice. So what do you do specifically, mate? Bit of everything, bit of nothing?
Bit of this, bit of that, just chilling, mainly just going over into the mall and having a wee perv.
So basically, if anyone's shipping container shop was missing, I had nothing to do with it. Neither did Kieran. Leave us alone. Get off my back. So you got family back there?
Maybe.
You're like, mate, depends where I've been.
Depends.
Could be.
Yeah, depends.
So that's me, chopper done here. I've had a bit of a sniff and a bit of a look round. Rebuild at Christchurch. And it's looking good, it's going okay. But I reckon I might give him a hand. See if we can speed it up just a tiny bit. So, I need to get back there and really pick up a shovel and start getting some stuff done.
He is more than welcome to, that is for sure. Well, coming up here on CTV News, the trams come full circle and your regional weather update.
Take a Break showcases some of the best that the South Island has to offer. From fun-filled adventures, great places to eat and stay, and of course, beautiful scenic landscapes. Take a Break, don't miss it.
Undergone home renovations? Looking for that special something to complete a room? Look no further than The Hitching Post. Their extensive range ensures you can find that special something. From plasma cut metalwork, to candles, artwork, weather vanes, or even a customised gate. So come on down to The Hitching Post, 722 Marshland Road.
Just 7 minutes north of Christchurch, Silverstream is a unique residential community carefully planned and developed within a rich natural environment. A family home or terraced villas, Silverstream offers a wide range of living options for every stage of life. The show homes are open. You can select your section, design your home and choose your builder. Purchase the house and land package or the terraced villa for streamside living. Silverstream, a community for everyone. It's closer than you think.
The world really is your oyster with farm-to-farm tours. Discover some of the world's best farming, scenery and cultural experiences. We work closely with trusted international colleagues in more than 30 countries to customise great trips for people just like you. For a hassle-free trip, call the friendly team at Farm-to-Farm Tours now or visit our website.
Make a date every Thursday night, the Owl and the Pussycats have returned. I'm the Owl and the women will be the panel. Make sure you get your letters and correspondence in and we'll answer your queries every Thursday, 8:30 here on CTV.
Welcome back to CTV News. Today marks Armistice Day. It's hard to believe, but it's been 96 years since the Great War. This year's local event also celebrated the 150th anniversary of our cadet forces. Around 300 people took part and attended the RSA-hosted parade over the weekend. It was pretty spectacular too. Well, the Christchurch trams were back on full track today, riding an entire loop. The trams have been running a shortened route since last November, but demand certainly hasn't eased. The trams carry just over 100,000 passengers in the past year. $1.5 million has been spent on repairing the network, and the good news just keeps on coming for Christchurch. There are plans to expand it to other areas of the CBD by February next year. And if that's not enough, the restaurant, remember the good old restaurant tram, that will be operational next month.
New Regent Street is humming. It's a far cry from Friday when a torrent of water flooded the street, soaking businesses and forcing the owners to close shop. Today there was a buzz in the air, a positive vibe after a harsh winter.
There's been a lot of hardships and disruptions along the way.
It was pretty tough. We're coming into the tourist season, so I think everything will pick up from now on and through the summer, which will be good.
The trams have been running a limited route for a year now, and in that time they've carried more than 100,000 visitors. But today, finally, they're back to their pre-quake route. Passengers will now stop at 10 locations, from Worcester Boulevard, Rolleston Avenue, Armagh and New Regent Streets. The loop will then end in Cathedral Square. It takes 25 minutes to go full circle, and the tram's owner couldn't be happier that it's finally open to the public and tourists.
It's almost 4 years, I guess, since the quake, but really happy to have them up running again.
The Christchurch City Council used $1.5 million of insurance money to repair the original tracks. With the full loop operating, the restaurant tram will be up and running again during the busy summer tourism season. An additional loop connecting New Regent Street to Restart Mall will be running by February, but this was originally scheduled to open last May, so why all the delays?
It was strengthening Armour Street Bridge, demolition of Victoria Apartments, and then the last 3 or 4 months was the sewer works under Armour Street.
When the trams are full, they're a boost for New Regent Street businesses, none more so than this tourism shop, Go Kiwi Gifts. The tram stops right outside.
The tram probably brings about 50% of our business into town, maybe a bit more. And with the city in two parts, it's really important to link those parts together.
Other businesses in the street will benefit too.
I think with the tram doing its full loop will help.
All of the businesses forced to shut their doors following heavy flooding on Friday when a pipe burst outside the Isaac Theatre Royal were back trading today. These shop owners are a resilient bunch.
I mean, everyone just sort of mucked in and cleaned up, and council came down with the street sweeper and everyone just kept trading through it.
It ruined a very nice floor, but we had great help from the team in the roadworks there. They came and helped the girls clean up.
However, these business owners are still waiting for answers so they can file insurance claims on the flood damage. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Well, new additions to Christchurch's Arana Park has got zookeepers jumping for joy. Native ducklings are now proudly on display for the public to see. Take a look at this.
We all know the blue duck. It's the one that appears on the back of the $10 note.
And the adults are really interesting because they do a lot of diving and things. They're designed for fast flowing water.
Their large webbed feet allows them to feed in fast moving water. One of the only ducks in the world to do this. And Arana Wildlife Park is doing their best to keep the species from becoming extinct. At their breed for release program, the blue duck are hatched and reared in captivity before being released into the wild once they're old enough and strong enough to fend for themselves.
Which is really exciting for us and really cool for them.
It's all because these ducks are facing extinction, with the population of the endangered species declining as each year goes by.
These guys, there's under 3,000 left in the wild, so for us it's a really significant program and something really good to be involved with. It's a direct conservation project, so it's really nice to know you're helping to boost their numbers in the wild.
At 10 days old, these ducklings are getting a taste of the outside world for the very first time. But zookeepers have no control over how many of these fluffy ducklings they will release outside each year.
Hopefully up to kind of double this number, but it's all dependent on the ducks.
The placid creatures, making it hard for zookeepers not to become too attached.
Even for, you know, these guys are very personable little ducks. You try and keep them as wild as possible and get them not attached to people, but they're a really cool little duck to work with.
Until these little ones are big enough to venture out on their own, they'll be making the aviary at Arana Park their home over summer. Emma Cropper, CTV News.
I want one. Well, now it's time for the region's weather.
Timaru sitting on 18 degrees. Tamuka and Geraldine follow the same path as well, sitting on 18. Ashburton, Methven and Rakaia also hit 18 degrees, and Darfield is not going to shy away from the rest, also sitting on 18 degrees. Leeston and Rolleston sitting on a nice 19 degrees. Lincoln and Christchurch follow as well. A nice 19 degrees for Akaroa sitting in the harbour there. Kaipoi sits on 20 degrees and Rangiora on 20 as well. Amberley is on 20, but Culverton hits 21 as well as Hanmer and Cheviot. Looking forward to tomorrow's temperatures, Timaru cloud increasing and showers developing with colder southwesterlies and some thunderstorms and hail possible during the afternoon. Tonight's low sits on 7 with a high of 14 tomorrow. Ashburton has a cloudy day in store with thunderstorms and hail developing during the afternoon as those colder southwesterlies freshen up. Your low tonight sits on 7 with a high of 14 tomorrow. Christchurch has a fine day at first, but thundery showers and hailstorms are possible later on with a colder southwesterly wind. The low tonight sits on 7 degrees with a high of 14 tomorrow. And cloud increasing in Kaikoura with showers developing and colder southwesterlies. Some thunderstorms and hail also possible for you during the afternoon, with a low of 7 overnight and a high of 14 tomorrow. Ask me what I did with my life. In other areas now, Tamuka and Geraldine sitting on 5 overnight with 13 tomorrow. Some cloud in the morning, then showers in the afternoon. Methven also some cloud in the morning and showers in the afternoon with a high of 14. Rakaia is back down to 13 tomorrow, also cloud and showers. Darfield starts out on 5 degrees, ending on 14 during the day. Akaroa follows that trend with 7 overnight and 14 tomorrow, starting out cloudy leading into those afternoon showers. Kaipui, Rangiora and Amberley much the same, starting out on 5 overnight with a high of 14 tomorrow. Culverton, Hanmer and Cheviot also on 5 overnight, a high of 14 tomorrow, starting out with cloud and ending with afternoon showers. Looking ahead for Canterbury, cloudy on Thursday with scattered showers and fresh to strong gusty southwesterly winds. Showers clearing at night though for a fine Friday for show day with cool northwesterly winds developing and increasing high cloud. Those milder northwesterlies will be freshening from the evening. Strong to near gale northwesterlies on Saturday morning with warm temperatures and high cloud. A change to cooler west to southwesterly winds in the afternoon may bring a few scattered showers. And mostly fine and sunny on Sunday and Monday with high cloud and moderate northeasterlies. You're up to date with your local weather. Have a great evening.
And news just in from Director Doug. He says Adore Me has taken out the main race of the evening. I'm not sure if he's watching this or what. And also some other positive news, I suppose. There was just one arrest at the Cup Day today, and that was for a minor assault. So I don't know if that's good or bad news, really. Thank you so much for joining us here at CTV News. Have a great night.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.